Hey everybody. Now when you see me beside a mid-sized truck in a trailer, you can almost guarantee that I'm going to be hauling some kind of gear or maybe a brand new side-by-side. But this video is not about how this truck hauls equipment. This is all about how this Colorado hauls babies. So in this video, we'll look at what it takes to get a couple of child seats into the back seat of this Chevy Colorado. Then we'll talk about the entire midsize segment and which one of these trucks offers the most space for your family. And finally, we'll tackle the general question, is a midsize truly big enough for a family with a couple of kids? Make sure you stay tuned. This is a Steven to the Rescue video because it's based on a question from a viewer. So if you have a question you want answered, send it over to ask, that's ASK at tfloffroad.com. And if it's interesting enough, we'll tackle it in a video. Anyways, this question comes from Kevin and it's not actually specifically what he asked. Now, Kevin wanted to know how easy child seats will fit into GM and Ram's double cabs and Ford super cab half ton trucks. Kevin, I didn't want to tackle your question directly because I don't have one of those models here. Next time I get one of those half ton trucks that's just one of the shorter cabs, I will definitely test it with my car seats and we will let you know about it. For now though, what I have here is this Colorado, this midsizer. So let's go ahead and take a look. The first thing you have to consider is the cab on your truck. Now here on this Colorado, we have a crew cab. Midsize pickups, most of them offer two different cab sizes, either a crew or then a smaller option. The name changes depending on the brand, but I will make a blanket statement right off the top. If you're going for a midsize pickup, you want a crew cab. You want the largest cab you can get if you have kids. Child seats, even in the crew cabs, are a little bit tight, so anything smaller, you're really going to be struggling. So I definitely recommend going for a crew. Now let's take a look at specifically what is in place back here to help secure child seats. And we'll also talk about my seats. Now this is a convertible child seat. It is still rear facing. As I mentioned, my little guy, Otis, he's still under 2 years old, so we're still rear facing there, which means that we are using these lower anchors down here, part of the latch system. So the latch system are metal anchors found right down here in the seat. You can actually see that one right there, and I'll show you on my seat that's actually using them. These clips clip right on to those metal anchors. I can take this one off, you can actually take a look. So this is the clip right here, and that end right there goes down, fits right onto those metal anchors, and then you just see when you're taking it off, you just touch that red button and it pops right off. But yeah, anyways, if you ever wondered what these little things are, some cars, they're like these little plastic nubs stuck right on the seat. That is letting you know that there's an anchor directly underneath there. So all of these trucks, of course, are gonna have the latch system. It's actually part of the law that vehicles have to have it. So that's not an issue. The issue is going to be space, right? It's all about leg room and how much space you have between the front seat and the rear seat. Now, that front driver's seat is currently set up in my car comfortable driving position, and you can see there's still that much space between the child seat and the front seat, and that's honestly ideal. You want to be able to be comfortable up there, be able to sit in this truck and not have to, you know, be stuffed up into the steering wheel, I should say, because you're accommodating that baby seat. So here in the Colorado, this absolutely works for me and my driving position. I stand at about 6'2". Now, let me tell you the numbers to give you a frame of reference for what that actually means in terms of legroom. So to demonstrate, let me just climb in here and I'll talk to you guys about the legroom. So this Colorado offers 35.8 inches of rear seat legroom. In the real world, I stand at 6'2". I can be comfortable in this back seat. It's just big enough for me. And that's sort of the story in most midsize trucks. The back seats for full-size adults are just big enough to be comfortable, but not overly comfortable. Now, this is 35.8 inches. There are actually two mid-sized trucks with bigger back seats, although the majority of them have smaller back seats. So rather than have me read them out, let me run a graphic for you right here, and you can see the sizing. So So if you want the most room for your kids, get a Jeep Gladiator, and if you want the least, go for that Tacoma. If you do get a Tacoma, it doesn't mean that these big convertible child seats won't fit, but just know that if you're in the front seat, you're definitely going to be adjusting your seating position to accommodate for the kids' seats. If you're okay with that, great. If you want more space, don't go for that Tacoma. Get a Jeep, a Honda, or even this Chevy. Back seats are becoming way better for kids these days too. I mean, look, even here in the Colorado, we have two USB ports and that 12 volt for power. So once your kids get older and they're using devices, we have all of the power back here that they're ever going to need. Parents out there already know this, but in a mid-size pickup especially, all of the rear legroom in the world still wouldn't be enough to house your two kids and all of their stuff, especially if you're going up to a cabin for the weekend, let's say. And that's where the pickup truck bed is incredibly important. And you maybe have figured this out by now, the big issue with the bed, well, it's not waterproof. You don't want all your stuff getting wet in the rain. So if you do have a family, you're probably going to want to look into a tonneau cover. I would suggest don't cheap out on your tonneau cover. Get something that's really going to protect you from the rain, because once you have your tonneau, your bed becomes a massive trunk that you can fit tons of stuff into. But do not expect to have two kids and a whole bunch of stuff up in that back seat. The other thing you should definitely consider when looking at these mid-sized trucks is crash test safety. So luckily we have the IIHS, the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety, out there doing crash testing, so we can actually look at the ratings and compare. Now, just about every one of these mid-sized trucks actually did pretty good in the crash testing. Oh, and of course, it's always fun to watch a couple trucks get crashed as well. The other thing the IIHS actually rates is the latch system in each one of these trucks. So they look at specifically how easy it is to use, how easy it is to access, how much pressure it takes to actually take those latches and jam them onto there. They really get detailed in their testing. Now, I don't want to break this all down for you. You might just fall asleep. It's not the most exciting stuff, but here's just a little taste of it. I'll give you a screenshot. And if you want more information, go over to the IIHS website. The short snippet that I will give you is just basically this. All of these mid-sized trucks didn't do that great. Basically, the IIHS says that most of them have latches which are hard to get to and offer a little bit too much resistance trying to put them in. I think that's mostly because they're all kind of small trucks, so the latch system is, you know, really sandwiched into a pretty small seat. All trucks except for the Honda Ridgeline. The Ridgeline is the only one that got an acceptable rating on the latch rather than just marginal like the rest of the mid-sizers. So I guess, if you want your baby seats to go into your mid-sized truck as easy as possible, according to the IIHS, you should buy a Honda Ridgeline. And now back to the question that we asked right off the top. Is a mid-sized truck really big enough for a family of four? Well, you know what? I'm just going to give you the straight up answer. No, it's not. If I had to buy a truck right now, it would definitely be a half-ton crew cab. Half-tons have gotten so big. All of the crew cab models offer nearly 40 inches. That's an extra 5 inches of rear leg room. They really are massive, not to mention the extra space you're getting for shoulder and headroom and the extra space you're getting in width. These trucks with two kids, it's just a little bit tight in there, you know? You just really, really feel cramped and squeezed in. You could make it work if you had to, but I think with the way truck pricing has gone these days, going for a half ton isn't gonna set you back, honestly, that much more. So yes, if you're asking me, if you want a family, if you wanna take your kids to the lake on the weekend, if you wanna get a cottage or a cabin, you do not want a mid-sizer, you want a half ton. But hey, that's just me. Maybe you already have a family and you live with a mid-sized truck, you're the person that I want to hear from. So let me know in the comments below what you guys think. Do you agree with me? Do you disagree? Is a midsize enough for a family, or should you go for a half ton or an HT? Now, that's it for this video. Go below, like I said, leave a comment, hit like, hit subscribe, and then come right back to the channel as we're gonna review this Colorado. We're actually gonna take it off-road, so don't worry. If you wanna hear more about this truck, well, that will be coming soon. So hit like, hit subscribe, and come right back for the latest news, views, and real-world reviews. See ya.